Reggie here, your friendly neighborhood bodybuilder and comic book collector, and I want to welcome you to another one of my videos. This video is going to be a poo-poo platter, and if you don't know what that means, you definitely want to stay tuned for the video. So yesterday I had a little bit of a snafu in which I recorded what I think was a pretty cool video featuring an unboxing from a subscriber of some really cool books. And then I also unboxed a purchase that I had made. And that was a little tragic. And I'll tell you a little bit more about that in just a couple of moments. But when I went to go look at the video today, I realized that the file was basically corrupted. The video was fine, but the audio could not be heard. I literally cranked it up as high as I could get it, and I still could barely hear myself. And the challenge is that you cannot re-record an unboxing. It's pretty much impossible because everything is already unboxed. Now, with that, I am just going to show you a couple of the books that I actually purchased. I'm actually reaching out to Joe separately, and I'll apologize to him for not showing his books, but I've like put them into my collection. I've actually boxed a couple of books up to send away to someone else as an A-OK. And so it's just that's so far gone that I cannot unring that bell. But I will show you a couple of books that I actually purchased. And then I'm also going to show you an A-OK that actually arrived from another subscriber. And it's actually a really cool thing. And then I'll get to some other stuff over the course of this video. And so if you haven't already figured it out, a poo-poo platter is essentially a sampling of some stuff that you put together and you serve up and that you hope that it's really good. That's the hope. But anyway, I ended up purchasing a book off of eBay. And it was a book that I really, really wanted for my personal collection. The price of the book was pretty low, which made me a little skeptical, but I looked at the pictures and I felt pretty confident that with the amount that I was spending, it was worth the risk. And I pulled the trigger. And I waited. And I waited. And I waited for the package to arrive. Because it was coming from Canada. I was trying to be super patient. I was also really, really busy at work. And I didn't realize that the package had actually arrived. It was actually sitting at my front door for a couple of days. Did not even notice it, but I did. Once I finally noticed it, I then came here in the comic book room and then I let it sit for like two more days. Then I honestly, as I was walking back to the comic book room, I realized that the box made noise when you walked with it. Kind of shook. And that gave me pause because a comic book in a box that makes noise typically is not a good thing, but I remain hopeful. I remain hopeful that everything was going to be okay. So I set up the camera, I sat down, and I recorded me opening the box. And much to my chagrin, exactly what I thought had happened had actually happened. The comics were placed in a brick with some cardboard. The cardboard was slightly bigger than the comic, but they were secured with scotch tape on two sides. Not four sides, just two sides. And it was one small piece of scotch tape that could not hang on. And so what ended up happening is the books broke free of the brick and the books just bounced around inside the box all the way from Canada down to California and lots of corner dings. Lots of corner dings on these books. And I'll show you a couple of the books that actually came in. This is one of them, Wildcats number one. This is actually the Wizard 19, issue number 69, Ace Edition, number 15. I'd actually never really seen this book before. And I really didn't want the book, but it was part of something else that I was really trying to get to. And what they also included, I think it was like Wildcats number 3, Wildcats number 1, both of which I actually have. But what I really wanted is this one. The gold foil Wildcats number 1. And the book actually looks a lot better than it did in the photos. But unfortunately, as I mentioned, it has a massive corner ding. I'm not sure if you guys will actually be able to see it on screen, but the corner ding was so severe that it actually rippled the backing board. It actually rippled the backing board because the impact on that corner was that great. The book overall looks fantastic, but each one of the books has a corner ding on it. And so the book was at least, the box was dropped at least two times because there's corner dings on some books on this corner and some on this corner. And so it was at least dropped two times pretty hard. So I actually reached out to the seller. I sent the seller photos of the books after I unboxed them. I said, hey, I actually have video of me unboxing this stuff in case you want to see it. Let me know how you want to handle it. And I signed it Reggie. And then I went to bed. When I woke up this morning, the seller had actually refunded me the entire amount. He apologized and refunded me the entire amount. And so I sent him a message and I said, I did not expect you to give me 100% of the money back and then also tell me to keep the comics. I said, you know, honestly, I would have been happy with like half, right? I would have been happy with like half because I still want the books. He said, no, I want to refund the entire amount. I don't want anything back. I want you to be happy with this transaction and I want you to think about doing business with me again. That is a good seller. That is a good seller. He can't pack a box, but he is a good seller. And I will honestly probably buy from him again. I may even place an order tonight just because he was such a good seller. So shout out to those people out there that do business on eBay and do it the right way. Huge shout out because it's a really, really nice book. I just wish it honestly didn't have the corner ding, but I'm happy to have the book in my collection. I may still go out and buy another copy now that doesn't have the corner ding. And unfortunately, I'm going to have to pay potentially more than what I paid for that one. But such is life, right? So this is actually something that came from a subscriber. And it came in a padded envelope, which kind of caught me off guard because I didn't really know what it was. And then it felt funny. It felt a little strange. And so I immediately opened it up because I wanted to see what was inside. And there was actually a really nice letter in here. And the letter starts off with, "You can share these on air." Shout out to you, Jay Simpson. Jay, shout out to you, bro. He says, "Reggie, I just finished watching the 3320 show and saw that you now have two challenge coins. Congratulations on your new addiction. Collection. I have been collecting for a year now and have managed to come across a couple of coins that I hope you will like to add to your collection. A good friend of mine was stationed at Fort Carson and he got me one coin from the Deputy Commanding General and the other from the 7th Infantry Division." And, Assistant Division Commander. Wait a minute, okay. "Enjoy your new hobby," is what Jay actually says. So let me show you guys what Jay sent over to me. And these are cool. These are really, really cool. This one is the one presented by Assistant Division Commander, 7th Infantry Division, Fort Carson, Colorado. So this is the one of the ones that he sent over. Hopefully you guys will be able to see that pretty well. Really, really cool challenge coin. It has a really nice like beveled edge. Both sides of the coin are kind of beveled. It is really nice. Really nice. Has some good weight to it. I don't know if they all have to weigh a certain amount. This one definitely is. Nope, they're the exact same size. I may have to check to see if they're all similar sizes. So this one is presented by the Deputy Commanding General, the Mountain Post, Fort Carson, Colorado. And this one also has a similar kind of beveled edge. It's just, these things are really cool. These are really, really cool. And I am doing my best not to have another addiction, but these things are really cool. So, Jay, shout out to you, bro, for sending these over. These things are really, really cool pieces, man. And I have two back there. I'm actually going to sit these two on the shelf right next to those others. I am definitely appreciative. Someone told me that I can get a holder. I don't want to get a holder. I don't want to get a holder because if you get a holder, it encourages you to feel that holder. So I am going to resist that temptation. So I have a couple of more books that I want to show you guys that I actually picked up from a comic shop a couple of days ago. But before I do that, I actually want to give you an opportunity to add a really cool book to your collection. So this is Creepy Number One from Warren Publishing in 1964. This is the first appearance of Uncle Creepy, a pretty nice comic book by all accounts. It is actually a Frank Frazetta last full-length comic strip is included in here. Really, really cool yellow cover book and pretty solid shape at a 7.0 with off-white pages. But if you're interested in this book, the requirements to enter the giveaway are relatively straightforward. You basically are a subscriber of the channel, you are a resident of the United States, a resident of Canada, or have a mailing address in the United States. If those things are true, you head over to the community tab, you find the post in which I'm talking about this week's Go Collect giveaway. There will be a link. You click on that link, you go to MailChimp. Once on MailChimp, you plug in three pieces of information. Two of them are relevant to you, and one of them is a phrase that I'll give you in just a few moments. You then hit the submit button, and now you are in the running for a pretty awesome book. You then tune in to the Ready, Set, Go preview show, which airs every single Sunday night at 7:30 p.m. Pacific time to find out if you're the winner. The phrase for this week is Frank. Frank is the phrase to enter this week's Go Collect giveaway. Good luck for that. Now, with that said, I want to show you guys a couple of extra books that I picked up. This is Marauders number 9. Huge fan of the Marauder series. Love this series. This was actually a pretty good issue. So if you are not reading Marauders, I definitely recommend it. The next couple of books are really just books that would lead you to believe that I'm like an Avengers fan. And I kind of sort of like the Avengers, but when you're digging in the long boxes and you see a couple of cool books, you go ahead and pick them up, even if you already own some of them. So this first one is the Avengers 246, and what makes this one cool, I believe that it is the first appearance of Maria Rambeau, which is Monica Rambeau's mother. Of Mighty Avengers number 246, first appearance of Mama Rambeau. This next one is Avengers 247. This is actually the first appearance of the Unimind. And so if you are excited about the Eternals movie coming out, there's a really cool thing that I don't know if it's the first appearance. I may have overspoke there. It is an appearance of the Unimind. But there's a really cool thing that happens with the Eternals where they basically fly and swirl and become a single mind, a single consciousness. And you actually see it here in this Avengers book. Really cool story arc featuring Star Fox, the brother of Thanos. And then there's also the continuation of that story in Avengers 248. So I had to pick that one up. And then this very last one is Avengers number 258, which I believe is the second appearance of Nebula. And so again, you look at these books and you think Reggie must be an Avengers fan. Maybe, sometimes. With that, I'm going to go ahead and wrap this video up. I want to thank you guys for hanging out with me. I hope that you enjoyed this video. And if you did, I want to encourage you to hit the thumbs up button. Leave a comment behind so we can mix it up in the comment section. If you need to reach out to me, feel free to do so on Instagram at Regie Collects, or you can send me an email to reggie@reggiecollects.com. Take care and good luck with this week's giveaway.